This video was made possible by EA Game Changers.
Good evening, my darling, darling friends, and welcome to The Sims 4 Snowy Escape review with me. For the second time on my channel, a full pack review. I feel very professional indeed. This will be anything but professional, so I'm just going to pre-warn you now. I've had about 5 hours of gameplay with this pack, with this expansion pack, shall I say. It is a beautiful, well put together expansion pack. And so far, I'm 5 hours in and I'm enjoying it. I am really, really enjoying it. The world is absolutely gorgeous. We'll go over all of that category by category in just a second. So yeah, I've had about 5 hours of gameplay. Haven't got around to playing with all of the gameplay just yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm also going to be live streaming gameplay on Twitch tonight at 8 p.m. So it's the same time that this video is going up. I will be live on Twitch with early access. Thank you to EA for sending me a code. I am not paid nor sponsored by EA to provide you with my thoughts on this. So all of this is coming from me. And I think you guys should know by now that I'm just going to be truthful with you. But all in all, I've really, really enjoyed this pack. It is well put together. Love that we've gone for a Japanese aesthetic with the world and the culture. I love, like, so I'm having a whale of a time with gameplay at the minute. I really, really am. So yeah, I think without further ado, we'll start off on my kind of rundown of everything that I've done so far. So first up is cast or create a sim. So hairs, clothes, you know where we're going with this. I'm blinded by my Google Doc at the minute of all my bullet points. So if you see me looking away, then that's what I'm doing. I'm reading. Yeah, cast. So lots and lots of, quite obviously, outerwear. There are lots of outerwear with this pack. So lots of jackets, jumpers, snowboarding suits or skiing suits. I don't know what you would call them. Weatherproof kind of like wear. Some lovely jumpers, some really, really lovely jumpers in there. Really liked some of the jumpers. Interesting choices for some of the colours. I know that they've got to kind of keep this Sims aesthetic with some of the clothing pieces, making them more colourful, a little bit garish here and there. Bright patterns, not my aesthetic, but I get why they did it for this pack. Really, really lovely. Also, another pro as well with this pack is the female hair is absolutely amazing. It comes with quite a few female hairs. I think there's about 8 or 9 different hairstyles. I loved them. Loved most of them. There was one that I was a bit unsure of, and it's the kind of long hair with the like big fringe. The fringe was just like a little bit chunky, and it kind of floats away from the forehead a little bit too much. Some of the cons for me, the male hair. The male hair, there was 3 male hairs, and I didn't really like any of them. One of them that I did choose for my sim self, it is something I've seen before. It's just something that is very similar to other hairstyles in the game. And we didn't get that many choices with male hair. And we always seem to get forgotten about in The Sims, which really pisses me off, actually. Some of the colours are interesting. Some of the colour choices for the hairs are interesting. Not my aesthetic for some of them, but they're still really, really lovely. And they were executed well. It was okay, I'm going to say cast this time. There were a few really nice standout pieces. Love this like baggy jumper that I'm wearing in cast at the minute. And also there were a couple of other male jumpers that I really liked. Females, they had a beautiful stripy blue and white shirt that I just thought was gorgeous on this sim. But other than that, I thought everything else was just okay. Okay, it wasn't great. It's not the best I've seen, but I will say the Sims team are now completely getting meshes right with clothing and they are looking absolutely amazing. Really, really are. I liked it. I didn't hate it. I liked it. We're going to leave it there, I think, for Cass. And move on to my most important thing, which is the build and buy. Now, the build and buy for this expansion, they nailed it. They absolutely nailed this. I thought there were some gorgeous pieces, absolutely stunning pieces. I love the swatches they went for this time. My favorite swatch in this one, quite strangely, because I'm usually quite a more dark wood aesthetic person, I loved the lighter timber that they used. in this particular kind of like collection of build and buy stuff, I just thought it was gorgeous. And they did like this muted greeny olive tone on quite a few of the pieces, including the sofas and the chairs. I loved that. Loved, loved, loved that. It's my probably my favorite execution of build and buy objects so far. They're going, I hope that they're moving away from this chunky, cartoonish furniture that I'm seeing and I have seen so much over the years with The Sims. And they're playing around with a bit more minimalism. They're playing around with a bit more up-to-date and current trends with furniture. And I want to see more of that. I want to see more of it. I want to see more. Yeah, the swatches are the best yet. The swatches are easily the best yet that I've seen on all the furnitures. Main reasons being neutral tones, warmer tones, whites, blacks, like I loved them. In the trailer, I saw this like grainy wood texture that I was unsure about. And then someone educated me saying, oh, in Japan, they do. I cannot remember what the process is called. I'll put the name up here on screen. And it's where they kind of like burn the wood to get all of the texture out and the wood itself. And I loved that. I didn't know that. So that made me appreciate it then. And I love it in game. It looks absolutely amazing. But yeah, the overall like minimalist style of these build and buy pieces is totally my aesthetic. I love it. So I'm going to definitely be using a lot of this furniture throughout all of my builds from now on, which I am so happy for. The textures are absolutely incredible. The textures, and that they're getting the textures completely right now with the new kitchens. I loved the bed. The bed that came with it was just amazing. I'm going to be using that throughout without a doubt. And the side tables that are not 8 foot wide, which I am totally here for. You know my thoughts on side tables if you do watch my channel. They're the perfect size side table. Keep the side tables that size, Sims 4, because that's how big a side table should be in my eyes. Yeah, not many cons with this pack. There were a couple that I've actually put down. Not enough flooring. I love the tatami mats or tata. I don't know how to say it. I'm so sorry if I'm crucifying that. I absolutely love those mats. I think they look great in The Sims 4, so I'm looking forward to playing around with them. But some new tiles would have been nice. Yes, we got an update with the new base, with the base game, where they put in several other swatches for the tiles. I think this is a reason why they did that, because they were thinking, we haven't done any tiles. So let's give them some new tiles, new, but just kind of recolored and... yeah, they're nice. The tiles look quite cool. I'm quite a fan of them. But again, their base game, I would have liked to have seen some that came with this pack, especially because there was a tiled wallpaper as well. I would have liked to have seen maybe a matching tile on the floor with that, maybe. But maybe that's just me being fussy. And also, I learned as well that they had a roof trim. I can't remember what EA Game Changer showed the roof trims off, but the roof trim was kind of like shaped like that. And they said that it wasn't good enough to ship with the game. It was great from what I could see. They looked great. I really wish that they left them in there because we didn't get any new roof trims. I would have loved to have seen that kind of match in with the new roof tiles that we got as well, which I'm probably showing you on screen now. We got some great new roof tiles. I would have loved to have had that trim that had that edge to it, which kind of matched up with the actual tiles on top. Like, I would have loved to have seen that. Something I haven't seen in The Sims yet is a different kind of roof trim and that kind of shape. I keep doing this. I don't know why. But overall, the build and buy for me was the winner. I thought it was stunning. I thought it was absolutely gorgeous. And I cannot wait to play around with more of it. I really can't. I've actually laid out, here you go. I'm going to show you around this room now. These are all my favorite pieces in all my favorite swatches. So... love them. Love, love, love. Especially the sofas. The sofas and the chairs and the stools. The kitchen is great as well. The new kitchen that came with it is absolutely gorgeous. I cannot wait to play around with more of those swatches as well. But again, I said I like the light timbers, so I went with that. The fireplaces. The fireplaces, especially that stone fireplace. I cannot wait to utilize that in a few more builds. I'm definitely going to be building some kind of Alpine Christmas lodge with that in because it is screaming out for it. But also the bathrooms and stuff as well. Lovely. Really, really lovely bath. I love the wooden bath. Absolutely gorgeous. And I'm absolutely for it. Now, I didn't show off all of the stuff in build mode, like the new Onsen object, and I think that was about it, really. Those kind of things. Main reasons being, I want to kind of play around with them a little bit more, and I'll show you a bit more of that once we go into the gameplay aspect of it as well. So, yes. But anyway, on to the next. So, the world overview of Mount Komorebi. Lovely. Really, really nice world. We've got kind of three separate, like, districts. Like, they seem to be doing a lot in The Sims 4, separating worlds off into different sections and different areas, which I like. One of my favorites being Windenburg because of all those different feels to each area. So we kind of got the mountainous area of Yukimatsu, which I'm probably going to crucify all of these, which is where you go up to ski. They've got rental lots up there, including an onsen bathhouse as well, which is a great addition to this pack, the onsen bathhouse. I'm definitely going to be playing around with that a little bit more, and I would love to build one myself. I'm definitely going to try and build one myself. Very similar to a spa. If you've got spa day, they work very similar to spa day. All of the interactions and everything that you can kind of do in them are very similar to spa day. So it's nothing majorly new. It's just nice to see a representation of Japanese culture in The Sims 4 now. With the onsen being a great addition. I absolutely loved it. Loved it. And then we've got Senbamachi. Senbamachi is the town of 1,000 leaves, as they say. So it's a bit more of the traditional area of Mount Komorebi. It's pretty, very, very pretty area. I will say it's got all the great hiking trails and stuff around it, which I love. The hiking in this game, we'll go more into that in the gameplay. It's great. I love that aspect of it now. And there was a few things to do here and there. Obviously, all of these lots were built by other EA Game Changers. Amazing to see EA Game Changing houses replacing EA houses. Please allow the EA Game Changers to build the world lots from now on, because this has made such a massive difference. It really has. And it would be lovely to see some other EA Game Changers hopefully get asked to do things like this. If you do want to ask me, I will definitely say yes. For your next world. I really would. So it would be lovely to see that kind of opportunity is shared between all of us EA Game Changers, rather than the kind of higher, sort of more popular Sims YouTubers. Not that that's a bad thing at all, because they did an absolutely amazing job, and I'm so happy and pleased for them. But I would love to see some other people get asked to do this as well. It was lovely. But yeah, that whole area is more of the traditional kind of Japanese sort of mountain town, or not even mountain town, just Japanese town or village. Gorgeous, gorgeous area. Now, the other area is Wakaba. And the last area is Wakaba. So Wakaba is the more modern looking area of Mount Komorebi. And it's nice. It's very nice to look at. The best thing about this area is it actually has got a lake you can go and swim in. I'm sure it's this area. I took my Sim self in there. It was freezing temperatures. Didn't care. Swam out into the lake. Love that aspect of gameplay. Love, love, love that. Love having a little swimming hole where your Sims could come and hang out and swim in the water. More of that in The Sims 4 world. I really, really loved it. But yeah, I found myself struggling to find what to do, because there wasn't much to do in this area, really. It was quite empty, quite quiet. A lot of the things were, again, as usual, and I will keep reiterating this with Sims 4 worlds, they were empty, kind of dressed shells. You don't get any gameplay out of them. You know how much I don't like rabbit holes anyway, but rabbit hole, there was nothing. It was just empty shells to kind of make the world look pretty. So really, there was just no replayability factor with that. You would have to build all the lots yourself to kind of make this area your own, which I don't mind because I'm a builder. I will be doing that anyway, because Mount Komorebi is going to be the next world that I do for my Let's Build the World series. So I'm really looking forward to playing around with this area. Also, the train that I really, really was looking forward to is not a working train. Again, it's just a bit of decoration. I don't think they should have included that in their trailer if we can't ride on it. It would have been nice to like go to the station, get on the train, and then make your way up to the actual mountain area itself. Like, even if, again, it was just a rabbit hole, a little bit of realism, would have loved to have seen it. And it's the same with the ski lift as well. I would have liked to have, In the beginning, I would have liked to have seen them walk in the doors, maybe get on the ski lift and then see the ski lift go up. But as I was playing the game more, I then realized that it would probably take too much time because as your sim comes down skiing down the mountain and they've got to go and get the cable car again to get back up, it would have probably been a bit more time consuming and annoying seeing your sim do that every time when you have to go back up again. So I understand why they did that kind of rabbit hole as I was playing the gameplay. And speaking of gameplay, let's flop on over into it, shall we? So far, again, this can't be a full gameplay review from me because I've not played too much of it. I've had 4-5 hours of it. I want more, which is what I'm doing tonight on Twitch. But I will tell you some pros of what I've really enjoyed so far and some things that I haven't so much enjoyed. But let me tell you now, there is not many cons really to the gameplay. I've been having so much fun. Now, the skiing and snowboarding is really fun. The animations on them are incredible. They must have worked so hard to get them. I may have cheated with my sim to make them a bit more higher up. Just so I can see what the tricks were. I needed to get a fancy screenshot with my sim self. So I had to get him to do some tricks. So I've cheated with the snowboarding. But it's so much fun. So much fun seeing your sims come down the slopes and stuff. Like, loved the toboggan as well. I thought that was really cute, especially when you were with another sim. Thought that was really, really nice. The hiking trails, as I said, they are really, really nice. Especially if you're walking with somebody. You can even walk with a group of people too when you're hiking through the woods. Now, I've not made any much friends with my sim self yet, so I didn't have a group of people to go on these hikes with, but I did find a man that I met in a bar. Don't tell Tom. Shush, it's my sim self. It's not in real life. And in fact, Tom's not even in this save file, so he will never know. Shush. But yeah, we were walking around and there was loads of cool parts where a centipede would come out and kind of like scare them, or they would stop in a place and take some photos, or they would stop and just chat and sort of point at stuff. And I loved all of that. It felt very realistic, and I'd love to see more of that kind of aspect in The Sims 4 in the future, especially with that new mechanic that they've got with the talking, walking, and loved that. Want to see more of that, please. Also, I loved the vending machines. I love a vending machine. I really do. And I know it's huge in the Japanese culture, vending machines. So I'm glad that they added this in. It's nice to be able to go. You can get hot food, cold food. You can get hot drinks. You can also get these kind of capsule-like creature things, collectibles. And that was really, really cute. But you can also buy all of your supplies as well. So your skis, your insect repellents, your snowboards, everything can be bought from these vending machines, which are great. And it really made it feel realistic, and allowed you to kind of like experiment with different foods and different objects and things. And I liked that. I really, really liked that about it. I hope to see more vending machines in the future. So it's going to be interesting playing around with vending machines on commercial lots and community lots from the future, because we've got them now. So I love that. And I know we've got some, but they don't work the way that this does, which to me should have been in the game quite a long time ago. But I'm glad that it came in with a kind of Japanese expansion. Very, very, very enjoyed it. Now, I will say the base game update with the sentiments and the lifestyles intensified this pack, really brought this pack to life. Makes me wonder if they thought about putting this just in the expansion itself before they thought, actually, this might cause some ruckus in the community. I'm just saying this, like, this is just what I was thinking. It's not true, but I was thinking maybe that was like a pack thing first, and then they thought, actually, let's bring this out as a free update. Allowing everybody to experience this. It adds depth to Sims relationships with moods and stuff, and people and the Sims can feel that person's mood and then they get affected by it. I love that. Adding and making the Sims more interesting should have been done 6 years ago. Should have been done 6 years ago, not coming up to the end of The Sims 4, which in my eyes, it kind of should be by now. I'm ready for The Sims 5, my loves. And I hope they don't make the same mistake as what they did with The Sims 4 and bring us an empty game and then fill it up over time, because I don't want to have to go through that again. And I don't think the community want to have to go through that again at all. But yeah, and that's what I mean. I've got hardly any cons with the gameplay at the minute. I'm going to play around with it, as I said, a bit more with the Twitch live stream tonight. So if you do want to come along and watch the gameplay, then feel free to join us. We're a big happy family over there, the same as we are on here. So come on over and join us there. But what I will do, if you're watching this in the future, I will leave a link down below to that video from Twitch so you can go back and watch it and see my thoughts on the gameplay a little bit more. Because at this time, I just haven't played too much of it. I've been in CAS for like 2 hours. I've been in build and buy for like, probably about 2 hours as well. And I've managed an hour to an hour and a half of gameplay. So I think we just need, I need a little bit more time of it before I can give my full conclusion with it. And what I will do as well is I will leave a full conclusion down below once I've played around with it a little bit more in the next week or so. So you guys can kind of see my final thoughts on the gameplay. But so far, I'm having so much fun with it. There's going to be tons of replayability with this as well, which I absolutely love. There's bound to be stuff that I haven't covered today too. Again, we only got the pack as EA Game Changers yesterday, very late at night as well. So for us Brits anyway. So I haven't had a chance to get this together properly. But from what I have seen, and I think what I'm showing you guys, I think you guys can make your own mind up on what you want to do about this and whether or not you want to buy it. In my eyes, is it worth it? Completely. Definitely, especially coming up to Christmas now, you're going to be able to do some beautiful looking Christmas builds up here in the snowy mountains and stuff. Like, I cannot wait to see what people do. But stunning. A stunning, stunning, stunning pack. And so far, it's getting a big whopping 8 out of 10 for me so far. But hopefully, let me play around with it a little bit more. Let's hope that doesn't fluctuate and go down. But the only reason I'm taking those kind of like 2 points off really is the worlds feel like they usually do with The Sims 4, a little bit empty, and a little bit boring, a little bit boring. But the rest of it is really well done. Really, really well done. So there we go, my loves. There is a review. We won't say a full review. Review so far of how I'm enjoying The Sims 4 Snowy Escape. And so far, I'm having a lot of fun. So far, I'm definitely having a lot of fun. You can come and see me have more fun, as I said, on Twitch if you do want to join me. If not, you can always watch the rest of it down below in the description box. I will give it a link as soon as I've finished streaming. And then you can see my kind of final thoughts on the gameplay and stuff there as well. But I think other than that, I'm going to see you all on YouTube tomorrow for a new video. Goodbye, my friends.